गुड आफ्टरनून
गुड आफ्टरनून सर
गुड आफ्टरनून गुड आफ्टरनून
सर व्हाट इज सुपर स्पेशल प्लेसेंटेशन सर
सुपरफिशियल प्लेसेंटेशन द गायनियम इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ मल्टी कार्पेलरी Here, Tanisha.
Yes, sir.
Here I drawn how many carpels now in gynoecium?
Five, sir.
Five carpels. Very good. So more than one carpel is there means the gynoecium is called a multicarpellary, no? Multicarpellary. Yes, sir. Yes, yes, yes. Multicarpellary. So this is one carpel, second carpel, third carpel, fourth carpel, fifth carpel. So multicarpellary, that gynoecium is a multicarpellary. Consist of several chambers, multilocular, in transverse section.
So what's the meaning of locular?
Locular means that chamber, locule. Locule means.
So can we consider it as a septum? So septum is present in that.
Yes, due to formation of the septum, this ovaries become into chamber. Due to formation of the septum wall. Due to formation of the septum wall, so that's become ovary become into chambers. Septum means what? Locular. Multilocular means what is the meaning of multilocular?
Multiple chambers.
Multicarpellary. The gynoecium is multicarpellary and multilocular. Multilocular. Locule means chamber. So several chambers are there. And this is a septum. What is the meaning of septum?
Wall which divides the ovary.
Ah, yes, yes, yes. Here I drawn how many chambers?
Six
chambers. So multicarpellary, multilocular. So this is the septum wall. Septa means wall. So here, in this multicarpellary, multilocular gynoecium, the several ovules are formed towards inner side of the septum. Is it visible clearly? Right. So this is the septum. Here I drawn one locule. It's outermost region of septum, and this is to a inner surface of the septum. So towards inner surface of the septum produces the ovules. The entire inner surface of the septum is forms the ovules. So that is superficial placentation. So the gynoecium is multicarpellary, multilocular, multicarpellary, multilocular. The ovules are formed, produced from inner surface of the septum. Is it clear enough, Tanisha? That is a superficial placentation.
It's yes, not sir, there. Yes.
It's not there in a syllabus. Right.
Thank you, sir.
Ah, it's okay. You're welcome.
Sir, in simple words, how can we define this?
So the presence of ovules around the inner surface of septum. The presence of ovules around the inner surface of septum. Okay, that is in simple. It's not there. Don't write about regarding this. It's not there in the syllabus. So this is the diagrammatic representation in this multilocular ovary. The ovules are develops from inner surface of the septum.
Sir, is it a type of axial placentation, sir?
In axial placentation, where they are formed? Exists region, right?
Yes.
That's
at the center.
Yes, that's at the center. That's the variations are there. Okay, free central axil, that similar. In free central placentation, the ovules are formed at axis region without the septum.
Without the septum.
Whereas in axial placentation, the ovules are present yes, at the axis region. Septa are there.
What is the example for superficial? Superficial placentation.
Superficial placentation is seen in nymphia. Nymphia plant. Okay, no?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, no. You're welcome. Next, today we will discuss about the structure of the seed. First, draw the diagram. What is the outermost layer of the seed is known as outermost layer
of the testa.
Testa.
Right. Innermost layer?
Tegmen.
Tegmen.
Tegma.
Tegmen, right.
The board is little blurry.
What about the remaining students? Huh?
Clear, sir. Now.
Have you done this diagram? Right, right. The structure of a seed, structure of embryo. Embryo is present inside the seed. How many cotyledons are present in a seed of dicots? How many
two cotyledons?
Very, very good. Two cotyledons. Okay, how many classes of angiosperms are there?
Two.
Two classes. What are they?
Monocots and dicots.
Monocots and dicots. Monocots consist of one cotyledon in seed. Monocotyledon plants consist of one cotyledon. Dicots of angiosperms consist of two cotyledons. What are the examples as per as per NCERT? The given example for monocots?
Rice, banana,
wheat, rye,
maize,
bajra,
wheat,
jowar, bajra,
jowar, bajra, rye. Dicots?
Gram pea.
So the outermost layer, of the seed coat is consist of called as testa. The seed is consist of two layers. Outer layer of the seed coat is called testa. The inner layer of the seed coat is called as tegmen. So it's important for both subjective and objective point of view. Objective point of view regarding this, the testa is a option one. Innermost layer of seed coat. Option two, outermost layer of seed coat, axis of embryo, option three, option four, radical. What is the answer? Testa.
Option two, outer most layer of seed coat.
Very good. Very good. Second option is correct answer. Outer most layer of the seed coat. Right. Tegmen is
option one.
Very good. Option one is
first option, sir.
First option. Very good. First option is correct. Right, outermost layer testa, innermost layer is tegmen, and hilum is a scar on the seed coat. Look here, so this is the scar. So with the help of the scar, the seeds are attached to the fruit wall. The seeds are attached. With the help of the scar, the seeds are attached to the fruit wall. What is the name of the fruit wall? Fruit wall is known as already Holland about that.
Pericarp.
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 Pericarp. Right. So hilum is the scar that's present on the seed coat. So with the help of the scar, the seeds are attached to the fruit wall. Next, the small opening is present above that scar that is called a micropyle. The small opening is present above the hilum that is called micropyle. What is a micropyle?
Sir, can you see what's the hilum? Once again, can you see, sir? Hilum.
Hilum is forms the scar on the seed coat. In which part of the ovule is become into seed? Which part of the flower is become into seed?
Ovule.
Here I drawn the ovule, structure of ovule. So this is a diagrammatic representation of the ovule. This white color stalk of the white structure is represent stalk of the ovule. Funicle, that is called a funicle or funiculus. Funicle or funiculus. And this is the upper part of ovule. Upper part of the, this is the upper part, and lower this is stalk like portion. The upper part of the ovule is called body. Body. The stalk of the ovule is called funicle or funiculus. And upper part of it looks like a bowl in shape. That's called a body, bowl shaped structure. Okay, the junction between funicle and body is called hilum. This is a funicle or stalk of the ovule. And the upper oval shaped structure, its body, in between the funicle and the body, hilum region is present. The hilum is present in between funicle and body of the ovule. Where the hilum is present? Please message me answer in the chat box. The hilum
funicle and body.
Between the body and the funicle.
So it is a junction in between the funicle and body. The hilum forms the scar on the seed. After fertilization process, the ovule is becoming to seed.
Sir, does it have any function, sir? Hilum.
Hilum is useful for attachment to the fruit wall or pericarp. What is the name of the fruit wall? Pericarp.
Okay, sir.
okay na, it's not fall off. So the pinion, with help of the scar, the seeds are attached to the fruit bar. If you are open that pea plant fruit, there the seeds are attached to the fruit bar. The seeds are attached to the with the help of a scar. Is it clear, Anna?
Yes, sir.
Oh, oh, right. What is micropyle in a seed?
Small
things. The microscopic pore from which water and action of gases takes.
Very good. The small opening is present at present above the hilum. The small opening is present above the hilum. That's called as micropyle. Here I drawn the embryo, the structure of embryo, diagrammatic representation. The embryo is present inside the seed. The embryo is present. Internally, the seed is consist of embryo, it's a small opening. What is the name of that opening above the scar? Micropyle. Right. So internally the seed is consist of embryo, is present inside the seed. The embryo is consist of the embryonal axis. The axis of the embryo is known as embryonal axis. What are the parts of the towards upper end of the embryonal axis is called a plumule. The lower end of the embryonal axis. So look here, this is the lower end of embryonal axis. The lower end of the embryonal axis is called a radicle. Radicle. Already have learnt about the functions of plumule and the radicle in morphology of the flowering plants. What is the function of the plumule? Radical function. The plumule is involved in formation of during germination of the seed. If the seed is sowing a soil, the plumule part of the embryo is gives place to shoot system. Leaves. Very good. The plumule part. While germination of the seed, the plumule part of the embryo is gives place to shoot system. Right, what is the function of the radicle? Radicle is involved in formation of during germination of the seed. Very good. That's radicle is involved in formation of a root system. So the embryonal axis, embryo is present inside the seed. Embryonal axis towards upper end of embryonal axis. That the plumule is present, it produces the shoot system. Towards the lower end of the embryonal axis is consist of radicle. Radicle is involved in formation of the root system. And the cotyledons, so here I drawn how many cotyledons? It's a dicot seed. Two cotyledons, very good. Two cotyledons are present. So this is one and two cotyledons. The cotyledons are consist of the food materials. So these are cotyledons are fleshy and consist of reserve food materials. So food materials are present in the cotyledons. So cotyledons are fleshy and the reserve stored food materials. So number of cotyledons in dicot seeds. How many cotyledons are present in dicotyledons?
Two cotyledons.
In monocotyledon seeds?
One cotyledon.
Which part of the embryo is produces the root system?
Radical.
Which part of the embryo is produces the shoot system? Plumule part. Yes. Which of the parts of the embryo is involved in formation of the shoot system and root system respectively?
Radical and.
Which of the parts of the embryo is involved in formation of shoot system and the root system respectively? Very good. Plumule and radical. Very good.
Plumule and radical.
Right. Which of the following parts of the embryo consists of embryo is fleshy and consists of food materials? Option one is the plumule. Option two is cotyledons. Option three is radical. Option four is none of these. What is the answer for this question? Please message me answer in the chat box. Which of the following part of the embryo is fleshy and stores the food materials? Right. Second option is the correct option.
So, what is the function of micropyle?
Micropyle is helpful for germination, absorption of. It's helpful for obtaining nitrogen if the seed is sown in a soil. What is the outermost layer of a seed cone?
Testa.
Testa. The small opening is. What is the name of that small opening?
Micro.
Right. So the seed is made of the several cells. In these cells, mitochondrial cell organelle. Mitochondrion cell organelle. What is the function of mitochondrion cell organelle?
Sir, to prepare energy.
Yes, that's involved in which process?
Energy.
Chloroplast is involved.
ATP in production.
Photosynthesis.
ATP production.
Mitochondrion
production.
ATP. That's energy stores. Respiration process.
Yes, sir. Respiration.
Yes. Mitochondria cell organelle is involved in aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration means that's respiration is occurs in the presence of oxygen. So here, for germination of the seed, energy is required. To respire, oxygen is entered into the cells of seed through micropyle region. The oxygen is entered into the cells of a seed through the micropyle region. During germination, that water is required. Water is entered into the seed through the micropyle region. Okay, so micropyle is helpful for obtaining oxygen, water from the surrounding medium. Is it clear now? Micropyle function regarding this?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, you're welcome. So without oxygen. The mitochondrial in cells of the seed, the mitochondrial cell organelles are not involved in respiration. If the respiration doesn't take place, the seed cannot germinate. So here the micropyle is useful for obtaining the oxygen water from the surrounding. Right. In some of the seeds, the endosperm tissue is present. The mature seeds, do you remember the structure of embryo sac or female gametophyte? We have learnt about the structure of embryo sac or female gametophyte. In which of the plant kingdom? The characters already covered. Yes, he has studied about the characters.
Angiosperms.
Angiosperms. The embryo sac or female gametophyte. He consists of a
triploid endosperm.
Okay, triploid endosperm is formed. How many cells are there in a embryo sac?
Seven
cells. Very good. Seven cells. The pollen grains are released from the anther. Reach it to the stigma. Double fertilization is takes place in which group of the plants? Double fertilization.
Angiosperms.
Very good. Angiosperms group of. Where the ovules are present. Right. Ovules are present inside the?
Inside the ovary.
Very, very good. The arrangement of ovules in the ovary, within the ovary is called?
Placentation.
Placentation, right. So the ovule is involved in formation of embryo sac or female gametophyte. Ovule is involved in formation of embryo sac or female gametophyte.
Synergids.
Yes. What are the parts of embryo sac or female?
Synergids, female gamete, central yes. Cell.
Female gamete, synergids.
Central cell and antipodal cells.
Yes, central cell and the antipodal cells. Like in angiosperms. Angiosperms group of plants, double fertilization takes place. The double fertilization leads to formation of triploid endosperm tissue. Triploid endosperm tissue. In some of the plant species, the endosperm tissue is present in a mature seeds. Mature seeds. Endosperm tissue. Endosperm is what is the ploidy of endosperm in angiosperms?
Triploid.
Triploid. And endosperm is triploid. So in some of the plant seeds, the endosperm tissue is present. Such seeds are called as endospermic seeds. Endospermic seeds. So before that, you have to know about the fertilization, double fertilization. Double fertilization. Double fertilization is the characteristics of angiosperms group of plants. Angiosperms. What is pollination?
So transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma.
Very good.
Transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma.
From anther to stigma. Right. After pollination, pollen grain is germinated on the stigma to form pollen tube. The pollen tube is carries two male gametes. How many male gametes are there? The pollen tube is carries two male gametes. The pollen tube is carries the two male gametes. The pollen tube is entered into entered, the pollen tube is entered into the embryo sac. So how many malgametes are present in a pollen tube? Two malgametes, very good. So malgametes are released into the embryo sac. One of the malgamete is fuses with the female gamete. One of the malgamete is fuses with the female gamete. And another malgamete is fuses with the central cell. So fertilization, the fertilization takes place in angiosperms. Fertilization is double fertilization. Double fertilization is takes place in the angiosperm group of the plants. One malgamete is fuses with the female gamete too. And another malgamete is fuses with the central cell. So here the fertilization is takes place twice in angiosperms group of plants. Hence it is called a double fertilization. So as a result of double fertilization, the one malgamete is fuses with the female gamete to form zygote. Yes. Another malgamete is fuses with the central cell to form the endosperm cell. Endosperm cell. PEC. Primary endosperm
nucleus and cell.
Cell. Yes. The cell, primary endosperm cell is consist of the nucleus. That nucleus is called a primary endosperm nucleus. Yes. PEN. PEN. Primary endosperm nucleus. What is the ploidy of the primary endosperm nucleus? Is it
haploid
or diploid or triploid?
Triploid, sir.
Triploid.
Triploid.
Triploid. Zygote is it?
Diploid.
Diploid. Female gamete. Female gamete is
haploid.
Haploid. Male gamete.
Haploid.
Haploid. Very good. Yes. The double fertilization is leads to formation of triploid endosperm, zygote, and triploid endosperm. Endosperm tissue. Endosperm is formed. So here the cells, a group of cells tissue, it's represent endosperm tissue. Like after fertilization process, ovule is become into after fertilization, ovule.
Seed.
Ovule is become into seed, right? If the endosperm tissue is present in a mature seeds, endosperm tissue is present in a mature seed. What is the function of zygote? The zygote is involved in formation of a embryo.
Embryo.
Yes. Zygote is involved in formation of the embryo. Here I draw the zygote. So this is one cell. Zygote is formed due to fusion of the male and female gamete. The zygote is involved in cell division to form multicellular, that's embryo. Here the zygote is obtained the food materials from endosperm tissue. The endosperm tissue is utilized by the developing embryo. In some of the plant species, the endosperm tissue is completely utilized by developing embryo. Endosperm tissue is completely utilized. Endosperm tissue is completely utilized by the embryo. Right, so here it's a seed. Suppose it's a seed. Zygote is formed in the sexual reproduction. After the fertilization process, ovule is become into seed. Zygote is developed into embryo. The embryo is utilizes the endosperm tissue. In some of the plant species, the endosperm tissue is completely utilized by developing embryo. means endosperm tissue is absent in a mature seeds. Such seeds are called as non-endospermic seeds. The seeds are two types. The two types of seeds are there based on the presence or absence of endosperm tissue. Based on the presence or absence of endosperm tissue. Non-endospermic seeds, endosperm tissue is absent. The endosperm tissue is absent in a mature seeds called as non-endospermic seeds. Non-endospermic seeds. What are the examples for non-endospermic seeds? P. Groundnut. Beans, flying seeds. In pea, groundnut, and in beans, flying seeds, the endosperm tissue is absent. The endosperm tissue is absent in the mature seeds of pea, groundnut, and beans. So these seeds are called non-endospermic seeds. In some of the plant species, the endosperm tissue is not completely utilized by developing embryo. Certain amount of the endosperm tissue is present. That's not completely utilized. In some of the plant species, the endosperm tissue completely utilized. In some of the plant species, the endosperm tissue is not completely utilized by the developing embryo. So if the endosperm is present, such seeds are called endospermic seeds. Endosperm is absent, such seeds are called as non-endospermic seeds.
Sir, if endosperm is not present, that means that it has completely utilized the endosperm, no, sir?
Yes, yes, in angiosperms. In mature seeds, that's why we are specifying that mature seeds. Endosperm tissue is absent in mature seeds. Such seeds are called as non-endospermic seeds. Is it clear, Nana?
Clear, sir.
Endospermic seeds. Castor and coconut, examples, the endospermic seeds, castor and coconut, plant seeds are examples for endospermic seeds. Endospermic seeds. So regarding this in subjective point of view, in theory, definitions, what are non-endospermic seeds? Example, give one example. What are endospermic seeds? Give one example. Okay, na? So endosperm.
So endosperm is nothing but that reserves the food materials, no, sir?
Yes, na. Reserves the food materials. In a coconut, for example, in coconut seed. What is the food, parts of coconut fruit, drupe fruit?
Endocarp, mesocarp.
Endocarp, mesocarp. Endocarp, mesocarp, epicarp.
Epi, meso, and endocarp, right. This is the endocarp of the coconut fruit. In coconut seed, that seed coat is attached to the endocarp. In coconut fruit, the seed coat is attached to the endocarp, the brown color layer is attached to the stony endocarp towards inner side. Right. It consists of initially that liquid. New liquid endosperm. Initially, that is in liquid endosperm. later it's become solid state, still learning this. That white here north is represent the endosperm tissue. Have you seen embryos in the coconut seeds? Have you seen embryos?
No, sir.
In some of that coconut seeds, the yellow color sponge-like structures will be formed. That is embryo.
Yes.
That yellow color in the, some of the coconut seeds. Endocarpo, the fruit wall, seed coats are fused. Right, the yellow color growths are appealing.
Sir, from where is that oil extracted, sir, from in coconut?
Oil is extracted from the endosperm tissue. Endosperm.
Okay, sir.
Endosperm tissue. Okay.
It's edible thing, sir, right? Endosperm.
Yes, endosperm is edible. Edible. Coconut fruit is not edible.
Is it a tissue, sir?
Yes, sir. Tissue.
Is it a tissue?
Endosperm. Endosperm is the edible tissue.
So it's actually white color, no, sir? White color.
Endosperm is white. Embryo is yellow in color. Embryo.
Sir, which is the edible part, sir?
Edible part.
In every.
Your voice.
Sir, the white color of the coconut inside the coconut.
That is edible endosperm tissue. White color, yellow color.
So that's not something that.
Sir, the green coconut that we get and the fibrous hairy coconut, they are different, sir. Or they are one stage of development.
Structures, sir, in seeds are there.
Sir, no, sir. The fruit of coconut. Sir, one that we use for worship, that one it has the fibrous layer, no, sir, on it. And that one which we used to drink, no, sir, the coconut juice. They are different species or they are the same type of coconut only, sir?
No, not same, different.
Okay, sir.
Right, now. Next. Do you have any doubts regarding this? Endosperm? Endospermic?
No, sir.
No doubt.
Sir, and the water in the coconut is the water absorbed from the roots. By the plant, the water present inside the coconut.
Wall, seed wall or fruit wall?
No, sir, water present inside the coconut, is it the water absorbed from the roots by the plant, coconut tree? No,
that is not that stage, liquid stage is represent, the endosperm, nuclear endosperm. In a endosperm cell, the nucleus is called a endosperm cell. The nucleus is called a, what is name of that nucleus? Primary endosperm nucleus. What is the body of primary endosperm nucleus?
Triploid.
Right, triploid. So it's formed due to the fusion of three nuclei, one amalgamate nucleus and two the central cell nuclei. Triploid in condition. So it undergoes the division, the repeated nuclear division. One nucleus, the primary endosperm nucleus, is divided to give rise to two nuclei, two to four nuclei, 4 to 8 nuclei, 8 to 16, 16 to 32, 32 to 64, like that, so on. The several thousands of the nuclei are formed. Thousands, several thousands of the nuclei formed. So that is represent liquid endosperm. In a primary endosperm cell, the nucleus of primary endosperm cell is undergoes the repeated nuclear division to form the several thousands of the nuclei. That liquid stage is represents the nuclear endosperm. Nuclear endosperm. So generally during cell division, the karyokinesis and the cytokinesis. Karyokinesis. Have you heard about the karyokinesis? Cytokinesis.
Yes, sir. Karyokinesis is the division of protoplasm.
Division of nucleus.
Division of nucleus.
Cytokinesis is division of protoplasm.
Division of cytoplasm.
Cytokinesis. Karyon means nucleus. Kinesis means division. The division of nucleus is known as karyokinesis. Karyon means nucleus, kinesis means division. The division of nucleus is called karyokinesis. Generally during the cell divisions, karyokinesis is immediately followed by the cytokinesis. But whereas in some of the organs, some of the tissues, like in coconut fruits, the karyokinesis is not immediately followed by the cytokinesis. Suppose during cell division, the one nucleus is involved in formation of two nuclei, means karyokinesis. First of all, karyokinesis, meaning karyokinesis process, the one nucleus is divided to give space to two nuclei. Later, the cytokinesis takes place. As a result of the cytokinesis, the cell's formation is takes place. The one cell is involved in formation of two cells. In most of the organs, in tissues, during cell division, the karyokinesis is immediately followed by the cytokinesis. Whereas in the exception cases, In this coconut fruit, the fruit already know the characteristics of the fruit. Okay, so one seed is present. Coconut fruit is consist of one seed. Inside the seed, the primary endosperm nucleus, the nucleus of primary endosperm cell is undergoes the free nuclear divisions, means several nuclear divisions are takes place. After the formation of thousands of the nuclei, cytoplasmic division is takes place. Then the liquid endosperm is becoming to cellular endosperm. The liquid stage is becoming to cellular endosperm. Gradually, the liquid stage is disappeared in coconut seed. Liquid stage is gradually disappeared. So that is endosperm, not a water, endosperm tissue. Liquid stages represent the free nuclear stage. Next, liquid stages become into solid stage, cellular endosperm. Is it clear now? At what stage?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In coconut. Embryo is seen in embryo after the sexual reproduction. In some of the coconut fruits. Okay. So after that, several stages are there during the development of embryo. Initially, zygote is single cell, later it's become two cell stays, four cell stays, right? Zygote is undergoes mitosis cell division, initially one cell, later it's become two to four, like so on. The multicellular embryo is formed. So after the formation of mature embryo, we can see the embryo in a coconut seeds. So it will take some.
Sir, the endosperm in coconut, it stores food, no sir?
Oh, endosperm is the nutritive tissue, consists of food materials of that endosperm. We can extract the oil from an endosperm of coconut, right?
Okay, thank you.
Any doubts regarding this?
No, sir. No doubt.
Okay.
No doubt, sir.
Okay. Next class, we will discuss about the remaining concept. Have you written the examples? Endospermic seeds or non-endospermic seeds?
Yes,
so which seeds consist of endosperm tissue? Endospermic or non-endospermic? What are the examples for endospermic seeds?
Castor and coconut.
Castor and coconut.
Non-endospermic. So tomorrow we'll discuss about the remaining concept of the seeds. Okay. Thank you, my dear students. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Okay. Right.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Now you're welcome.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Okay.